Built in 1752, the Lent House was one of the few remaining Dutch sandstone houses in Rockland County. Historic preservationists, activists, and locals watched in horror as the house built by Abram Lent, a man who fought in the Revolutionary War, collapsed in a pile of rubble. Few people knew the Lent House existed. It sat in a sea of retail, surrounded by Lowe's, a supermarket, and a hotel.
In that one.
The developer was indifferent. On a Friday, town officials met with Graff. They assured him they were not going to pull his permit. He choked.
Save them.
Not long after, a group met to revive efforts to save the John Green House. New blood brought fresh ways of thinking. Entrepreneurial ideas took shape. Preservationists were taking a page from John Green's playbook. John Green built the Colonial Sandstone in 1819. He was a prominent entrepreneur who put Nyack on the map with a seaport and a major thoroughfare in the county. But his star never rose. His name never stuck. Over the years, committees of citizens and appointed public officials worked together to dream up a plan for both houses and the land. The efforts were an exercise in futility. The fate of the property was rigged.
As best we can.
It had been done before, on 24 acres of land once owned by Jim and Pat Cropsey, retired farmers. In 2006, the Cropseys, childless and aging, sold their 24 acres in a 60-40 split to the county and to the town. The property included a Revolutionary-era Dutch barn, another treasure that has fallen into disrepair. When the town and county purchased the Cropsey land, they gave the barn to the Rockland Farm Alliance to use. But the group does not seem to have the resources for its upkeep. After a hard fight, Clarkstown did the right thing and gave both the barn and the house historic designation. But the barn is in dire shape and needs restoration. Who will pay for that? Within 4 months of acquiring the house, John Green members made impressive strides. Through Indiegogo and other efforts, they raised more than $15,000 in donations. The coalition planned to hire an architectural firm specializing in historic preservation to assess the structure, make recommendations, and chart the future restoration. All this in just 4 months. Not every old house can be saved. Still, when the bulldozer annihilates an historic house, more than a structure, more than brick or stone, more than worn pipes or broken windows are lost. It wipes away history, erasing who we were and where we are. We'd like to believe governments perceive the value of preserving and protecting historic structures. It rarely turns out that way. Historic preservation boils down to the efforts of ordinary people who do extraordinary things.